Goose, you know, start rapping and shit and doing his stuff. And, you know, I've heard him rap before, you know what I'm saying? But I never knew that it was like on some serious shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, I never knew he was really like, you know, putting his pen to the sheets and really trying to like, you know, take it there with it, you feel me?
This is when we lived on the west side. We used to call an attic the Chattic. But no, you know, he used to be up there writing all the time, and he just told me, shit, you know, I know you be thinking shit, write it. And I just wrote. And I had like, I think it was like 8 bars or some shit. And like, nah, boy, you can really rap, bro, if you take it serious. I could say he was impressed a little bit, but now he know, for real.
Goose was always just, you know, the quiet and reserved one in the room, you know what I'm saying? He never was, I told him all that time, he's still like that, really. He just really starting to really open up, and he still ain't all the way open right now. Pause. Like, he, you know, he be in his head a lot. He be a lot of self-doubt, or, you know, I think it's just a lack of confidence. And I think, you know, just being around with me, taking him everywhere and, you know, seeing this shit and seeing how this shit work and what this shit really about and how this shit go, I think that's gonna, you know, help big time with, you know, helping him gain that confidence that he need and shit.
Quiet kid. He was, like I said, he was quiet. When he did speak, it was like a sentence. It was short. It was to the point. So to see him rapping, I think the first video I seen him do, I said, wow, where the hell did this come from?
She right, like he never was like that, you know what I mean? Since he was a kid, like he was always, you know, he wasn't a talker. He wasn't the guy in the room who, you know, the class clown or whatever. Like, you know what I'm trying to say? Like, he wasn't that dude. He was just always, you know, the quiet guy in the room, the cool dude, you know what I'm saying?
Conway the Machine. Mr. Machine, man. He's been my mentor, man, throughout my whole life. So about 14, that's when I probably started writing to myself. But he always used to tell me, like, I be knowing you be thinking shit, you might as well just say it. But I never do, so it'd be like, all right. So I used to just stay writing to myself. Nobody, it became like a, you know, a diary damn near for myself. When I go through shit, when I be stressing and I'm mad about something, I just write.
You know what's crazy? I didn't even know bro rap till last year. Like, he was at my house. He came to my son's graduation, and I think I like left for like an hour. I went to the gym, I did something, and my son was in the room with his boys. They was already doing what they had to do. Before I left, I just remember him saying, man, let me go see what Kamani in there doing. He got up, he went in the room. I came back. When I came back, they had a song done. I didn't even know my son rapped, you know, so all that was a big, I didn't even know he rapped, so that'll be the first time I heard him rap was like last year.
Goose is incredibly, like, that's what I mean, like, hearing that shit and knowing, like, the type of nigga Goose was and seeing him come out that shell.
I'm so proud of him, because to see him just, like, come out of a shell, it was something different.
By the way, nigga, look, Goldie lost, got Fox and me gone. Say the wrong thing, be gone. Bullets singing to you like a sweet song. Was a wild little nigga trying to be grown. Reminiscing, drinking nigga with some sea gone. We own part of my life, sit at the table when we talk about life. Had to slow myself down, I was off to the right. Folks might try to come off me tonight. But I'm that spark, I'ma shine like the snow in the light. Shovel my path and I'm throwing away. Be on my ground, old nigga. Action with the time, go nigga. I be in my time zone, nigga.
I never thought in a million years I'd be doing half the shit I did. Now to be doing this, like I said, I never thought, but it happened, and you know, it's a blessing. And you have to respect. You gotta respect the shit that's going on in your life sometimes. Not even sometimes, all the time. Because you never know where to take you. Just push yourself. And that's something I always did with myself. Even when I was stressed out, mad, I still push myself. Regardless of what I'm going through, you feel me? So it's a good feeling. I'm happy. I enjoy it.
I'm very proud to see that he finally found his path. It took him a while. And I was wondering when it was going to happen. And it finally happened, and it was a surprise. I thought he was gonna choose some type of career, but I mean other than rapping, like, you know, a working career. But yeah, it was a shock.
Well, he got that voice. He can rap, put the words together, but that voice is just, you know what I'm saying? So if I had to describe how he sound, gutter, got pain.
Goose give me the same feel like a big nigga popping his fly shit.
Instantly, like the first song he did, I was like, you got something, Goose, like, you feel me? Like, I heard it. So Goose always been solid from day one, a good artist, you feel me? Like, I feel like he's got a lot of presence to him, so he sound good.
I wanna, you know, touch other aspects of music. Definitely, like, I don't just wanna focus on rap music, like to dabble a little bit. I like to reach beyond my palate.
The thing with Goose is though, Goose, he's like super swaggy. You know what I'm saying? I've heard him do a little bit of everything, and he's got a whole different sound when he wants to have that sound.
It's therapy for me. Helps me get through life. It's therapy. When I write, even when I'm in a booth or even when I get on stage, like, I just learned the stage is a therapy for me. It helps to get off my shit, what I want to say or how I feel at the time.
And then he was like sitting in his car writing. I'm like, and he was like, Ma, what you think of this? And I listened to it, I'm like, damn, this is something that I would actually listen to. So, because I'm very hard critic. If I don't like your shit, I'm not listening to it. And that goes for Conway too. I'm glad he finally got confidence in himself, because apparently he must have been able to do this forever, but never displayed it. So when he finally decided to display it, I'm quite sure everybody in this room was like, wow.
And Goose be trying to act all quiet and shit, but Goose ain't quiet, man. He got y'all fooled with that shit. Like, if you walk in the room and you look around, Goose might be sitting there, might not even be saying nothing. But he got a lot of shit to say.
Hey, this is why I'm Goose. This is why I'm Goose. I'm not your everyday person. I'm just abstract.
I hope he stick with it, because he definitely has a lot to say for some reason. Now, he's finally out. He finally came out of his shell. And it's like he belonged there. He used to be in the bathroom, in the shower, singing, practice what you preach. from Barry White. Like old school song. When we first heard him singing that, he must have been about 10.
Well, give your mama a hug, man.
Oh God, get away from me.
And that's real shit.